It's not, it doesn't like go through my network or anything like that, so. Yeah.
Your connection isn't strong enough to go live.
I know, isn't that the most annoying thing? Every time we go, we start, it's like, you're ready to start talking, but then it's not ready to start listening. Which is quite annoying, actually.
Oh, it's going.
So I'm gonna stop our recording here. And I'm gonna click the post. Post to Facebook. All right. Yeah, man. Yo, John, we're just getting started here. I'm going to stop this, delete this. And you got your mic there, Rich?
1-2.
Awesome. All right. So we're going... So if you go to superjoepardo.com/live, we're getting ready to start it off here. So I'm going to hit record, and you can join in the chat there as well, superjoepardo.com/live. All right, why is it's so noisy? I wonder if it's because of that fan. Of course it's because of the fan. Oh, I thought we were gonna have more people here, but I'll just unplug these. All right.
How are we doing? Right.
I think we're looking good here. I'm gonna.
Is that hashtag how to dream on all social networks?
That is hashtag how to dream on all social networks. All right, I'm gonna hit record here, and we're going to start recording here. And hey, everybody, we're live here in the Minhaf studio at my house, like conveniently located
in
at my
house
here in South Jersey. So I'm here with my buddy Rich Quick, the famous rapper who just got back from a world tour. I'm sorry. Well, it might as well have been a world tour.
Yeah, no. Not yet.
Well, we're getting there.
But I was in another part of the world.
Another part of the world, yes. He was in another part of the world. He was in the UK again for a second tour.
Second run.
And yeah, so I'm glad to have you back here in the studio talking. And tonight what we're doing is it's 3 hours long. We're going to be raising money for Give Kids the World.
Give Kids the World.
Yes.
That's hashtag how to dream on all social networks.
Yes, yes it is. And I'm sure we'll be hearing that quite a bit tonight about how hashtag how to dream on all social networks. So, so tonight this is the second anniversary of Dreamers Podcast. I was just saying to Melissa that, like, it feels like I was just here.
Yeah.
Like, you were just here.
Yeah,
like,
right here.
I know, but it went by so quick.
Yeah.
Like, really, really quick. So I'm super, super pumped to be here, super pumped to be raising money for Give Kids the World. For anyone who doesn't know, Give Kids the World is it's an organization. They work with the Make-A-Wish Foundation. And what they do is when there's a kid that's dealing with a life-threatening illness, they like, hey, I want to go to Disney World, I want to go to SeaWorld, I want to go to Universal. So what happens is they fly their parents and them and their whole family down to Orlando. They give them a house to stay in, a car to use. They have ice cream for breakfast, like, every morning for the kids. They have parties at night. They get tickets to all the parks, Universal, Disney World, and SeaWorld.
So they hook them up.
Yeah, they really hook them up down there. So it's a wonderful cause, and I'm so proud to be able to raise money for them, you know, utilizing the show to raise money for a wonderful cause. So we're here, second anniversary of Dreamers Podcast. We're live on Blab. We're live on Facebook Live on two different streams.
Yeah, they're
plus
they're,
over here.
I don't even know where to look. I'm like... Hey,
there's so if you want to come and join us in the video chat with through Blab, go to superjoepardo.com/live. Now, if you want to donate, there's a button at the bottom of that page. It's a real big button with a heart and the logo of Give Kids the World.
And go if there. You want to support hashtag how to dream on all social networks, hashtag how to dream.
Yes, so you could add hashtag how to dream SuperJoePardo.com/donate will take you right to their donation page. You're not donating to me. This isn't going through, isn't going through me. Like, you're going straight to them. And the goal for tonight, now last year, Rich, we raised $600 in 2 hours.
That was amazing.
It really was. I'm still impressed. But this year, I think, I know that we can raise $1,000.
Set the goal higher.
Yes, but we're here for 3 hours.
Right.
Last year we had a party here, so if you watched the video from last year, we had a party. It was great. We had lots of people from all over came down.
Tacos and all that.
Yeah, there was lots of tacos.
There was some margaritas flowing in here.
And it was a wonderful time. And but this year, you know, I just had my first child the other day, Ava, and tomorrow I have a. One of the previous guests, Paul, is having his bachelor party. We're having people come here. So it was like, okay, Melissa's leaving the house, taking Ava with her, going down to her parents' house for the weekend. And that means we're here.
Yep, having a Rowdy Dreamers podcast.
Yes, yes,
anniversary
we are.
Event.
So we're here. We're raising money for Give Kids the World. I have some announcements that I want to make a little bit later on. Sort of a big announcement. It is a big announcement to me, at least.
Okay.
So I'm looking forward. So it's a little bit of a teaser thing,
yeah,
right?
All right. Now I'm interested.
Yeah.
Big announcement's coming soon.
Yes, later on tonight. If you're not joining us in Blab, you should be. Go to superjoepardo.com/live and join us on Blab. There's a chat room. You can call in, and when we start doing the games. We'd love to have you come in. The thing that I didn't get to mention was for every single game that we complete, whether it's me, you, or somebody in a video, I'm donating $10.
Oh, that's awesome.
To Give Kids the World of my own money. So I would love for you to come join us in the video chat. It's superjoepardo.com/live. There's a link right above the video on there that brings you right into the chat room with us. So you can hashtag how to dream right along with us.
On all social networks.
On all social
hashtag
networks.
Hashtag how to dream. And also I find hashtag how to dream as it be clued into the network and what's going on. And you could probably get the links through there also.
Yes, you definitely can. Right now we have Dedzy Doll in the chat room here. Thank you so much for joining us. And thank you for the congratulations on the new baby. Really, really appreciate it. All right. So, Rich, while we're waiting for we're waiting for things to, you know, kick off, get some more people here in the chat room with us and do some of these games that we have. You can't really see it in the video because it's not widescreen, but we have some games set up over here. Rich, how was your trip?
Oh, man, it was awesome. It was legendary, as I like to say. Also, I got deathly ill. So it was like, so much was going on. It was like, I got the flu when I got there. And I kind of stayed sick the whole time, but had an amazing tour. Did all types of interviews. I shot videos, performed some great shows. Opened up for Dead Prez out there. And then got the flu again. Twice I got the flu.
How long were you out there for?
I was out there for a month.
A month, and you got the flu twice.
And I got the
back to back.
Yeah.
That's horrible.
In less than 30 days, I wound up with the flu twice, man. It was crazy, but I will tell you that I put in I gave it 110%.
I would expect myself. You to.
Yeah,
I mean, you don't get to go to Europe every day.
Yeah, you got to make You got to make sure that everything was that I was really making my mark out there, and. I like to think that me and my manager, Chelly Chell, shouts out to Chelly Chell. I like to think we do a good job of that everywhere that we go. And also want to shout out Beats and Bars, my homie DJ Trixa, who's the one that really brings me out there and provides me this opportunity to tour. And I tour by myself. Like, I headline the tour. Which
is really incredible.
Yeah, not a lot of artists.
We talked about that before,
yeah,
right?
Not a lot of artists get to do that.
Coming up, and it's like, oh no, the pressure of being the headliner.
Right, and it's really no. I mean, it's
a headliner with a flu.
with the well, that was crazy. See, that was my last show was in Liverpool, and I started to get like a really bad cough again, and I'm like, well, there's no way I'm getting, you know, the flu again, and then I started running the fever, and by the end of the by the time I was about to take the stage, I was so ridiculously ill that I.
But you are ill. Yeah. I mean, outside of that.
Oh, I was ill on the mic, but I had I thought I was going to collapse up there, man. It was crazy, but I definitely gave it my all anyway. I guess against my better judgment, and I didn't wind up in the hospital, so I'm very grateful for that.
That is good. We're all thankful for that.
Yes, absolutely.
What was like the best part? You know, do you have like a favorite memory from the trip?
Man, just reconnect. Like it was my second time there, so kind of just reconnecting with my friends that I made the first time around. It was dope. You know, to see familiar faces. Like these are my friends now. When you tour with people, you know what I mean. It's like it's an experience, and you grow together. You know what I mean. So. It was dope to reconnect with them. The dopest thing that I did, though, was I recorded a mixtape out there.
Oh, you did?
Yeah, with DJ Trixta, and that's coming soon. So it's new music. We shot some videos for it, so we got that on the way, too.
Wow. Okay, so that's pretty awesome. How much time did you get to spend on that?
Basically, every day I was in the studio. Like, every during the day, I was in the studio from morning until whenever the show was. And then, you know, we would, you know, leave the show, go home, go to sleep, go back to the studio. So it was a daily routine. And I was trying my best to, you know, knock out features and everything like that, knock out verses for other people's projects and collab with artists out there. And it was important to have that studio resource, and that resulted in a really dope mixtape. It's really dope, man. I can't wait for people to it's I really like it.
When will we get the pleasure of getting to hear it?
You know, I'm not exactly sure. The plan is to go back there in summer of 2017, so it would be a good idea to probably release it sometime before then. And that's all that I can really tell you right now, because I really don't know.
Well, that's awesome, man. I hope that it gets out before the, you know, the 2017 mark, for everybody's sake. But
oh, I got other things I'm working on too on the way. There's a ton in the works that's coming soon. That particular project, I don't have a release date for.
Okay. All right. Well, when you do, let me know so we can get it out there with hashtag How to Dream on all social networks.
On all social networks.
Yeah.
Hashtag How to Dream.
So, all right. So, well, you know, I got to say, I really appreciate you coming in. A little bit later on, you're going to be performing three songs live here in the studio. You know, Does it feel like coming off a cloud when you had to come back to America?
Oh, hell no.
No?
No. No. Keep in mind, I got the flu twice in less than 30 days. My body had been pushed to the limit. I was broken. Like, it was rough. That getting on that, like, 8-hour plane ride home was really, you know, like, rough. I was really grateful to be back in the United States. As far as coming off a cloud of the vibes that I caught out there, absolutely. But I kind of coast on them. I keep those experiences in me. You know what I mean? And take them with me everywhere that I go. So.
Well, yeah, definitely. I could see getting that time off. Like 8 hours to relax and hopefully get some sleep. I mean, personally, I can't sleep on planes.
Oh no, I couldn't. I was running a fever, which I'm quite certain, y'all, all you people out there in internet land, that you can't really travel with, you know, a fever.
But I wasn't going to reschedule my whole, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
So I was traveling, you know, wedged in between two people. I'm like sweating and I just feel like death. It was the longest 8 hours of my life, and I'm watching like Home Alone 2. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
To add insult to injury, is like, and I'm watching something like Home Alone 2, and it was Home Alone.
Yeah. So just to remind everyone, go to superjoepardo.com/donate to Give Kids the World. That's why we're here tonight. That's why we're going to be playing all of these games, these Minute to Win It games. If you want to come and I'm donating my own money, you go to superjoepardo.com/live, click on the chat, like there's a link right above this window right here that we're in right now in cyberspace, and go and click that link, and that will take you to Blab. If you sign up, you just have to use like your Twitter handle or your Facebook handle, and then you can come in and we can watch you play Minute to Win It games with us. And for every game that you complete, I'll be donating $10 of my own money.
And I plan on killing these games.
Yeah, I know. Well, you want my, you know, you want to take all the monies.
I plan on killing these.
You're gonna Robin Hood the money.
Yeah,
of course.
Oh, absolutely. And while we're doing it, we hashtagging How to Dream on all social networks.
Yes, we are. All right. So in the meantime, why don't we get set up for the first game? Right. I mean that. Why not? Right. It's been like 15 minutes already. Let's see. I don't think. Where are we at here? Let me refresh. Oh, nothing there. All right. So let's get. You want to do the Oreo challenge first, or was it? Let's save that for later. Let's see if we can complete in 60 seconds. You know what's funny is actually
he said you want to do the Oreo challenge. You know what? We'll save that for later.
Yeah. Well, because
you don't want to start off with the silliest.
Why'd you say dinner? I don't want to eat dessert.
Oh,
yet.
You don't want to eat dessert. Oh, okay.
Well, no, that's it. The silliest. We'll save that for last.
Like, let's just start off with the let's warm up. Ridiculous one.
Let's warm up with the. So we have a shot glass, right? A shot glass in a cup of water, and we got quarters, and we got to get three of those quarters into the shot glass before 60 seconds.
Easy.
You know what's funny is normally we would be using I would be using my phone to take the time, but we're both live streaming on Facebook Live. At least we're supposed to. You might want to check yours to make sure it hasn't crashed, because Facebook Live has been very unreliable as of late. But it's okay, because you know what? I have my laptop here, and my laptop has a timing program.
Yeah, I'm definitely not on Facebook Live, bro.
No, they crashed. That's why you gotta face it towards you, like mine. So I know when it crashes, it's time to get it back out and set it back up again. Let's see.
You can use my timer on my phone.
Oh, because you're not on Facebook Live. Okay, yeah, that's fine. All right, so let's see if we can get the camera over here. Let's see, moving this camera. Let's see. Let's reverse this here. So we gotta turn this camera over here. Now I actually have an extension cord on this here. Can you grab my phone real quick there? All right, cool. So we're gonna take this camera. See, this is live. And last year and
that's
like.
That's why you gotta face it towards you, like mine. So I know when it crashes, it's time to get it back out.
So this is live.
This is live. Yes, this is very live. Very live. Okay, so now the camera's like been up my nose. We'll just set the camera up over here. Boom! All right, there we go.
Oh, that's nice. That's nice.
So now we got
a nice angle.
The shot glass there, and then we'll just let's see here. Tell you what, why don't we move this down just a little bit? All right, so now we got that angle, and we're gonna set up this Facebook Live over here. And
whoa,
almost dropped my phone. So if you're watching this on Facebook Live, come join us at superjoepardo.com/. Click the button or the link just above. Oh, it was already the other way. Click the link just above. Just above the video of us right here on Blab. And what you can do is, you can actually, you click that link, you put in your Twitter information, then you get the video chat, and you can come hang out with us in the video chat, and do these games. We're doing them for charity, for Give Kids the World. So we have a 1 minute timer. Since you're my guest, I'll let the guest go first.
All right.
How does that sound? So we got, we got the camera all set up here. I think we're good. So we're gonna go.
So in a minute, I have to get three of them in.
Into the shot glass.
Into here.
Did I mention that we didn't? I don't actually have a shot glass in the house, and Melissa had to go buy one.
Melissa had to go out and buy a shot glass.
Yes. Well, I don't drink, so.
Well, there's no reason for you to have a shot glass.
Right. Although, I mean, she thought we had one, but we didn't.
Special occasions, like you gotta drop some quarters, do some water. Is it like
for charity?
Yeah, for charity. You never know. That's what I'm saying. Things like this come up. It's good to have a shot glass around. And you know, shouts out to Melissa for going out and purchasing a shot glass. We have the shot glass right here.
It's a nice plastic of the plastic variety.
Yeah, nice plastic shot glass that y'all can have around the house in case people want to do shots of you know, water.
Yes. So
quarters.
Shots of quarters. So all right. So if you're watching this, I'm doing this for Give Kids the World. I'm donating $10. If Rich Quick can get three of those quarters into that shot glass in 1 minute, so I'm gonna count down, Rich.
All right.
3, 2, 1, go. Oh.
Okay.
Man, this is a lot. This looks a lot harder. Plus, the shot glass is made of plastic,
and it's actually moving around.
It is moving around slightly. Oh man!
Oh,
45 seconds left, Rich. Come on, you can do it. This is for the kids. Now we only have so many quarters here too, so it's gonna make it kind of interesting once we have to. Oh, look at you! I had to be up on the banked it off the wall. Did you get the second one in there?
Sure did. He's got
two.
Oh man,
30
oh,
seconds.
Man.
You got plenty of time, Rich. You got this. All right, there way to go. Get three, man. To get three.
Listen, I got five left. Can I get a bonus round?
sure. I'll do an extra dollar for each one that you get in. And he's going to get all of them. So we're at 11, 12,
boom.
13.
Wow.
14.
Wow.
15. That's 15. $15 for Give Kids the World.
How about that?
I gotta mark that down. Let me mark that down. $15. And if you want to donate, go to superjoepardo.com/donate to donate to Give Kids the World. I'm going to be donating $15 thanks to that. So, Rich, take over for a second. I'm going to go empty this cup out so I can get those quarters back, because we change is a commodity here in this house.
All right. So, this is Dreamers Podcast Anniversary Show. I'm happy to be back again in the building, celebrating with my good friend Joe Pardo. We are hashtagging How to Dream on all social networks. We are raising money for Give Kids the World. And, you know, we're playing some fun games for y'all. I go by the name of Rich Quick, guest in the building. And you can log on to superjoepardo.com/donate to donate, and superjoepardo.com/live to be involved in the chat and everything that we got going on in here tonight. And my man Joe is back in the building, about to see where how many quarters he can get in.
I'm back. No, in the chat room, Deadzy Doll said that he couldn't hear us very well from this view, from the Blab. But if you could, Desi Doll, let me know. I just turned up the gain a bit on the channel, so let me know if that's any better for you, or good enough, if you will. So, Rich, if you would not mind, so I guess I'll first three get $10 for Give Kids the World, and the next, every single one after, will be $1 for Give Kids the World. So, and I'll have a minute to do it. So I'm going to put my mic down now.
All right. Time to get serious, Joe.
Yeah, I'm ready. Ready?
On your mark, get set, go.
Oh, man, this is not as easy as it looks. There's one.
Boom.
They probably can't hear two.
Two. Three.
All right, so we got 10. I can't tell.
That was one. All right, so we got 10 plus an additional two.
Two. So it's 12. That's 13. No. 13. 14. 14. Ah. Did it go in? I don't think it went in.
14.
No. Ah. I missed it.
So we got $14. Got 14. So my man got the three and an additional. How many additional?
Four additional.
Four additional.
So that's $14 right there. So we're already up to $29. Plus, we received a donation from Doc Kennedy for five. So what was 29 plus five? I can't do math.
It's 34.
34. Oh, the rapper can do math. I can't do math. The podcaster can't do math.
I can't really do math, bro.
That's okay.
I'm trying, though.
All right, so that's a healthy amount of money right there already.
Yep, we're doing good.
We're doing it. All right, so let's flip this back around. Again, if you want to come and join on the video chat, go to superjoepardo.com/live. Where did I have this camera set up?
Right there.
Let's see. There we go. All right. So back up a little bit. Okay, so all right, so yeah, so we're at $34 already.
$34 raised,
which is wonderful. So I should fix the camera for the blab crowd over here. There we go. Hopefully the sound is a little bit louder, and you can hear us in the chat or the blab room.
Hello out there in blab land.
All right, let's move this out of the way. All right, so is my mic working? Yeah, well, it is, but it's not, for some reason, it's not quite as loud as yours was, but I can fix that later.
One, two.
Testing.
Yeah, mine is loud.
Wow, yeah, yours is like way loud. Hold on, because mine's unplugged. Testing, one, two, three. Testing, one, two, there we go. All right. Let's turn it down a little bit, just a hair. All right. Well, Desi Doll, I know you just said there we go, but let me know again in the chat room if it works. You know, if it's still good. All right. Good. All right. So I wanted to talk a little bit right before we get to the next game. About everything that's been going on the last year, right? Because this past year, it's seen like a lot of things have happened for me, both in the business,
life changing things, everything. You got all sorts of miracles and gifts, and yeah, how about this year, huh?
Yeah. So this past year, since Dreamers Podcast started, it's been pretty. It's been pretty wonderful, right? I mean, there hasn't been a whole lot of bad things happen to me, put it that way. So since last year, let's see, I wrote my first book, right? Like that was just before the 1 year mark. Then
excellent book, and it's one of the books that I took with me to Europe when I went on tour.
Oh, and, wow! Thank you.
Yeah, man, it's a good read when you're like traveling. It's just
like a traveling man over
yeah,
here.
Yeah, it's a good traveling read because it's not like it's something that you can pick up and put down. You know what I mean?
Well, according to one Imagineer, you could read it in three or four sittings on the toilet. So he's not, putting it down.
Well, no,
it's so short.
Yeah, well, what I'm saying is it's a book that you can absorb, you know, bits and pieces of it at a time. Which is when I'm traveling, that's what I'm doing. I'm getting on a train or I'm getting on, you know what I mean?
Right. And you don't necessarily have data.
Right.
So you can't just pick up the phone and be like, yo, what's going on? Like, can't do that because you ain't got that data power. Right.
So you released the book.
Yes. I released a second book called How to Dream Big and Win. That came out in like the third quarter of last year. So, that book, while it hasn't, I didn't make as big of a deal about it because a lot, like, I have talked, it's kind of like an extension of my How to Dream Big talk, right? Which is great. Mm-hmm. Absolutely love doing it, especially for kids and for dreamers and entrepreneurs. Like, it's great. It's motivational, but it's educational. And that's the thing, like, I growing up, I hated the whole rah, 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 like, we're gonna, you know, go live our dreams big things. And, like, I'm not that guy. But what I am is an educator.
You're kind of that,
like,
guy.
I don't know. I don't see myself like
not in that way, let's say.
Like, the obnoxious, like, I want to punch this guy in the face because he's so positive and so in my face.
Almost out of the realms of reality is what you're saying.
Right. Well, they're not grounded in reality at all.
Yeah, right, exactly.
So for me, it's like, okay, so I want to, like, educate not just, the idea, the principle of go and dream big, but the idea of let's talk about how to dream big so we can be successful at it, right? So that we can make steps in the right direction so that we can make a difference, not just for ourselves, but to inspire others to make that step without, nobody likes failure, right? So, like, I want to set people up to succeed. And getting people riled up, while good, if you're not giving them the proper information on how to go about go be a rapper, but, like, the process that you should go through to figure out if you should be a rapper.
Right.
Right?
The steps you gotta take to initially.
Exactly. Because not everybody's like you, where you grew up and you were doing this. Like, you knew from a young age, like, and not just knew about it, but you knew about it and you were doing it from a young age. Not everybody gets to do that. A lot of people, and this is, from the experience of talking to, because we're at like 230 episodes now, a Dreamers podcast.
Wow.
Yeah.
Congratulations.
Thank you. This is 231. So not everybody gets to that opportunity to know what it is that they want to do. So it's really, really, really important for people to make that, to take those steps. To figuring out what it is that they wanted to do, like, especially if you're not a kid, or if you are a kid, like, whittling it down to what's the base of what it is that you wanted to do when you grew up. Then and a lot of times, even people that aren't or don't think that they're living their dreams, they actually kind of are, because if you break it down to, like, the base of what it is that they wanted to do as a kid, they were probably doing that in some way, shape, or form, just not, well, I wanted to be a rapper. Well, I didn't end up being a rapper, but I ended up writing I ended up being a journalist, but it worked, right?
They take things on as hobbies more instead of actual, like a career path or something like that.
And there's nothing wrong with that. For me, like, a lot of people are like, oh, it's do or die, and this is it. And, we're taught to be extreme about everything that we do in order to be noticed. But to me, it's okay if that's what you want. If you want it to be a hobby, there's nothing wrong with that. But if you want it to be something serious and you want it to be something that you can take to the next level, then you need to make those steps. You need to take these steps that I've written about to achieve the goals that you are setting forth for yourself. That was a mouthful. So that was, like, that's one thing, writing a second book. Another thing I did this year was I took Dreamers Podcast and all of my stuff, like, everything, and I brought it to Super Joe Pardo com. And the reason is because, like, I knew this even before that, but it's easy to get off track and think like, oh, you know, the thing that I'm building is going to be huge and everyone's going to want to use it and everyone's going to want to be a part of it. But the fact of the matter is you have to recognize what your brand is. And in my case, Rich, I'm the brand, right? Like, if I went away tomorrow, it's done. It's over. Maybe somebody picks up, like, the idea, and that's great, and I hope that they do.
It's plenty of dreamers out here.
That is very true. But the idea is that the reason that the people are, like, you know, attracted to Dreamers Podcast and all that, and the reason you're here isn't because of Dreamers Podcast, it's because of me.
That's true.
And recognizing the brand and what should be the brand is, like, super, super important. So it was like, okay, so I'm the brand.
And if I may
nobody
say...
Nobody else can be Rich Quick.
No.
Exactly.
Absolutely not.
Exactly.
But with what the brand itself represents is the most important thing to me. Just because it's weak, I really believe it. Maybe I am that guy. Maybe I'm that out of reality guy who says, like, I really think that we can do anything that we set our minds to. And I think that we're both testaments to that. You know, we kind of do what we want, and we follow the waves and spread positivity. Man, it's a good thing.
Yes. Yeah, for certain, man. So it's like I wanted to take everything and bring it down to me, and you know, the reason for all of this is because I'm the one doing it. So I was like, okay, so I'm going to register. I have registered, like, joepardo.net and all that. But I was like, you know, and I wish Matt was here right now. He's been my co-host for a little while. He about, like, in 2006, right? So we're going back like 10 years ago now. Mm-hmm. He doodled a stick figure and wrote Super Joe Pardo across the chest. Yeah. It had a cape and everything. And I thought about this and I was like, you know, I wonder if superjoepardo.com is available. And guess what? It was available. Yeah, for like $10 a year. So I was like, okay. So this
nobody wanted superjoepardo.com, right?
Apparently not. They didn't recognize the branding power that it brought to the table.
Right.
And so because of that, I was able to get, you know, to snatch it up and make it happen. I took about a week to build that site, and, you know, it was absolutely, it was awesome, you know? I got accolades from people that I didn't even realize that, you know, liked what I did so much. And I admire their work, and they were complimenting me on my website design. So that was, you know, really awesome. Shout out to Beatrice Feeney, because last year, July 4th, we got to hang out at the Polynesian Resort in Disney World in the bungalows overlooking the castle, which was absolutely awesome. I got to meet Jeff Barnes. He's the author of The Wisdom of Walt. Hold on a second. The Wisdom of Walt here. You can see it in the... It's like... I know the lighting in here is not great.
Shout out to Jeff Barnes.
Yeah, shout out to Jeff Barnes. And we got to interview him. He actually flew from California to Disney World to be there on July 4th to hang out with us. And it turned out we were supposed to interview him. Me and... Krista Joy, who I do the Living the Dream podcast with, you know, she was like, can we use the bungalow to record the interview? And it turns out, yes, we could use the bungalow. So there's this, like, awesome video of, like, the bungalow is it's amazing. So to get to shoot video there, like an interview there, was absolutely wonderful. So that was great. What Beatrice Cini is saying, I'm listening to Jeff's book on audiobook right now. That's yes, it is. So I'm super, super grateful for that. Super grateful for the experiences that I got to have with Chris the Joy, with Living the Dream podcast, which started up like right after the one, you know, the 1 year anniversary of this show. And so let's see, what else happened? We had a baby. Well, actually, we found out that we were pregnant that weekend, or that week that we were down in Disney and got a hand rose. So it was a really like cool time for us.
That's awesome, man.
Yeah, it
really has been a great year for you.
Yes, it has. And it's like it's just getting started. So like having Ava has been amazing. It's been tough, right? Because having a baby, I usually have her set up here in the office in like this bouncing thing, and it's tough. It's really tough, right? Because as long as she stays asleep, I can get work done. As soon as she starts crying or waking up and crying, then I gotta like stop what I'm doing, and it's tough. Because you're in the zone. You're in the work zone.
Yeah.
You're focused in, and
nope. Baby takes priority over all.
Right. And should. But it doesn't make getting work done any easier. That's the problem, right?
Right.
So, super thankful for that. And as we've gotten, now she's just over 9 weeks old, you know, she's starting to get, like, a little bit of a personality and...
Starting to get more interesting.
Yeah, a little more than just sleeping and mostly sleeping. So yeah, I'm starting to feel that changeover from being a caregiver to being a father. There's definitely I'm seeing the arc in my own life.
Seeing how this takes place.
Yes.
Like,
yeah.
Oh.
This is how it goes. So it's not as hard as like a lot of people make it out to be. The whole changing diapers thing isn't very hard. I changed some diapers, not many, before now.
I'm not into it.
No, I mean most people aren't, and I'm not into
it myself.
It's quite understandable, Rich. I don't blame you. It's definitely very magical to have those experiences. The other thing I did was I put together some courses. Like I developed some other products at the end of last year. For people who want to learn how to put together a website, that people who want to learn how to, podcast, people who want to learn how to shoot video and edit video, so those are all on superjoecarter.com as well. Like, it started out as this idea, right? So here's a lesson, right? I put together yourdreamplatform.com, going along with the whole dreaming thing and all that, and it's wonderful. But I realized when I was getting into it that the reason that most of the people that were buying the package of video instructions from me was because of me, not because, you know, I was some amazing person that, you know, showing people like, oh, this is how it, you know, getting people interested to click buy.
They were supporting you.
Right, and they're, you know, and it, because they wanted to know how to do some of the stuff for themselves and all that, and it's a great,
right,
you know,
right, right.
Developing courses is a great way to do that. So I was like, you know, that's also what led into like, okay, maybe I shouldn't be trying to, you know, develop other brands so much as developing my brand, because if I develop my brand for Joe Pardo, superjoepardo.com, then what ends up happening is I can pull more people in that want to learn from me because of me, rather than they want to learn and, you know, it's really tough to get, like, search rankings for that kind of stuff.
What do you mean?
Like how to learn how to build a website. There's plenty of other sites out there that'll teach you how to do it. So, like, why compete on that level? Compete on what I can do, which is build the Joe Pardo brand, and then that, you know, have people want to learn from me because of the other stuff that I'm doing.
Right.
Right. So that's why it's like, okay, gotta bring everything to Super Joe Pardo.
I'm seeing a clearer picture of the vision that you have. It seems like that this year, it would have had to have been this year.
that it kind of came together in this way. Am I right?
Yeah, yeah, it did. I wish that I hadn't spent so much time trying to build your dream platform and instead just building the classes, because building a whole website and everything, like, took an immense amount of time. The course videos wasn't too bad. That wasn't so bad. But the, you know, it was more about the whole, you know, building out the website, building out the membership and all that. I would not recommend it, especially if you already have, like, a large following. It's hard to build two brands or three unless people already know you, trust you, and want to, you know, you have that wow factor that people gravitate to whatever you do. If you have that, which most people don't and will never have, then you can do that. Otherwise, if you're the brand, be the brand. Or build one brand. Don't build two. It's really tough.
That's something that I've focused on all my career in terms of branding myself. Whereas, you know, you know that it's me. If you see, I use it. It's crazy. I wore the chains.
Yeah, where's the chains?
I left the chains in all the room.
I didn't even see you when you came in.
I came in full Rich Quick costume and everything. With the skull cap, the glasses, the chains. And it became, you know, a thing that people recognize. And then you know, it's they'll seem like doppelgangers. Like, I'll get tagged on the internet and doppelgangers and stuff like that. But it's really just somebody else with glasses and a hat. But people, when they see that, they equate it to me. So it's like, you know, branding yourself. But I didn't, like, set out to do that. Just kind of...
Well, that's what it's supposed to happen. It's supposed to just happen.
Yeah, it's just you.
Yeah, and unless you're trying to, like I said, build one brand that isn't you, then you gotta do things. You know, things like that will pop up where people like gravitate to the glasses. Or I mean, look at Elton John, right? He always had, like, he doesn't always have the same glasses on, but they're always, even in the like reading glasses, they're big and fancy.
He has, you know, several pairs of glasses.
Yes, yeah. So that's the thing. So finding that, you don't even have to find it, because people will find it for you if you keep working at what you're doing and keep digging. So for me, like, the other, you know, great thing that's happened is I feel like, I don't feel like I've arrived just yet, but feel like I'm getting pretty darn close. You know, just before we got on this call, because we're going to be getting ready for a performance from Rich Quick in a few minutes here.
Oh yeah.
Oh, hopefully. Do we got the email?
Good question. I'm sure I have it.
Okay.
We'll figure it out.
We'll figure it out. If not, you can just acapella it.
Of course, I can do it. We can do anything.
Yeah. All right. So yeah, I got a phone, or I got an email to speak at a you know, for the potential to speak at an all female entrepreneur summit conference out in Cleveland.
How about that?
Yeah. So I don't know if it's definitely gonna happen. I gotta submit the talks that I want to do. But they're definitely highly interested in what I do and how I do it. So there's a pretty big potential for me to make that happen.
I predict another great year, man.
I think this year's going to be way better than every year. I mean, I don't know. It's hard to stop having the first kid, right? So, like, I don't want to... aside, we can talk about the idea that we're going to have an amazing 12 months starting... Well, actually, yeah, today.
Yeah, starting today. And we'll be here next year.
We will. It'll be, you know, the goal to me is to get this, like, I want to do this in, like, a hall. Tickets and, like, have a big party. I mean, last year we had a party. I wish had I known that Melissa wasn't going to be here tonight with Ava, I probably would have made the decision to have a party anyway. Though it would have been like pizza and chips kind of party instead of like tacos and margaritas Melissa always likes to go out loud.
Wildly prepared food.
Yeah. So, like that's one of the things, like, going forward this year, not only do I have other things, in the tank that I want to create, and I'm already, like, working towards creating them, but, like, speaking and, you know, I've gotten more, business consulting clients this year. Already, like, going into next year, Just getting everything bigger and better, doing more posts on my website to help drive more traffic, to help bring more people to me and the brand, and help people along the way, like figure out not just online business and not just, you know, their dreams, but like life in general. You know, there's lots of things that tie into like things that hold us back, right, Rich? Like there's reasons that we hold ourselves back, and those are types of things. And it doesn't necessarily have to be towards dreams, but just like giving 110% because we feel that we're not good enough, we feel that we're not worth it, we feel all these things that we feel that whatever the reason is, that's not good enough. We need to give more, and we need to figure out what it is that makes us feel great.
Right.
Great. I mean, that's the thing. What, like, it's not just, hey, well, I'm okay. How are you? You're okay?
I'm all right.
No, you gotta be great. Like, that's what we need to be. We need to be great. That's how I feel. And that's how I feel, like, 99% of the time is I feel like I need to be great. And if I don't feel great, then I need to do whatever I need to do. I need to sit down and figure out what it is that isn't making me feel great, and then actually put into plan how I'm going to make, you know, to change that.
Yeah,
because
change it.
We all deserve to feel great. It doesn't matter if we like people, don't like people. Like, we all deserve, everybody deserves to be happy and feel great. We just don't have to talk to everybody. You know, we don't always have to talk to everybody. It doesn't mean that you can't not like people.
You don't have to get along with each other.
Yeah, you don't have to get along with everybody. But, you know, at the end of the day, everyone deserves to be happy in their own little world.
Joe, how you feel, bro?
I feel great. We're here.
That's nice. I feel great, too.
Let's see what we have.
Hashtag how to dream on all social networks. That's for sure.
I just want to point out, we got 3 more donations here. I'm just going to, I'm like all up in the camera with my light in my face. Let's see. So we're up to 96, like $70 plus my 30. We're already at $100-some for Give Kids the World.
Boom.
We're going to get ready here for Rich to perform one of his first of 3 songs before we get into another game. If you want to come hang out with us in the video chat, we're live on Facebook, but also if you want, come and hang out on Blab. It's superjoepardo.com/live. You click the link right above the Blab session, the video, this box thing that you see us in. You click that link and then use your Twitter handle to get in. Comment on the video. I'm donating $10 to Give Kids the World for every single minute to win a game that we play with you on air and that you complete. So far, I've already donated $29.
Boom.
Yeah, $29 right here.
Because we're both pretty good at that quarter and the shot glass thing.
Yeah, you know what I need? I need like a bigger glass or something, like, to make it a little bit harder. But it's okay, because in the meantime, we gave $29 to Give Kids the World.
It was for a good cause.
Yes, it was. So, we have some other games, including the Oreo Challenge, where you put an Oreo cookie on your forehead, and you sit in the back of a chair, and you try to get it from your forehead to your mouth. And if we do that...
That's a hard one.
It is hard. I think last year, I got in, like, seconds. It was, like, pure luck. It just, like, fell from my forehead into my mouth. $10, boom.
That was easily the funniest thing that we did that night, watching everybody contort their face trying to get this Oreo to their mouth.
Yes, it definitely was. And had a really great time last year. I'm so thankful for all the people that came out from up to like over 3 hours away to come be here at the house. Absolutely amazing. All right, so Rich, do you have your music or? Let's see, what do you got, man? All right, so you got. All right, let's see. Let's see if we can get this hooked up. I'm not sure if it's gonna play properly or not. I just gotta plug in. Let's see. Come on. Here we go. All right. Oh.
Hi Blab, y'all don't look so happy I'm here. Facebook Live, y'all don't look so happy I'm here. Hi. Hi, here. Here I stand, a grown man, with a notebook full of rhymes and no plan. See, I walk a fine line and dance, and I drink fine wine with my fans. Y'all take the high road, I pave my road out of sand. Follow my footsteps to promised land. Comfortably chilling at the top, and I believe that I'ma do it, cause I'm never gonna stop. Watch as I do all the things you wanna do. The truth standing right in front of you, I'm gunning you, sonny. You think you sick? I think you might need a drink. Your chickle now faster than a sinking ship. Yo, rich quick, who you think you is? When you go out, how many free drinks you get? How many freaks freak to freak you with just to get you to notice that they freak legit? Is this real life? Could this be true? That rich quick is more successful than you? My dear God, this can't be. Mr. Love Life, start a fan stampede. Hi, y'all don't look so happy I'm here. Why y'all don't look so happy I'm here? Hi. Hi. Yo. Diss me, I diss you back. Psych, no. Diss me, I laugh cause your ish be whack. And I love life so much, I just relax and chill back in the city with some chicks we bagged. I could talk about the pain of this game, but I'm sick of saying that. Totally and wholly happy that I'm slam rap. And they in fact couldn't do it if they wanted to. I got my own piece of pie, meeting right in front of you. And y'all's not hungry as me, I wanted to. Hug me a freak, Larry Berry day of the week. Reacting, I'm acting up. What? I know sick rappers that I make sick, cause I'm sicker than your average lame is. Till my name is famous as this, y'all can keep claiming I'm nameless. Yeah, they know that I'm winning, chill. Ain't no reason to keep it a secret, but keep it real. See this deal? I don't need this deal. See this bottle? I'ma keep it chill. Till we get in the league and build, until they get on their knees and believe it's real. Chill back, relax, just quick. Came through the back with a duck chick. One time for myself, Jersey family. Two for the ones that hate me. Three for 525, Page Street at 18. And if you gotta ask, you don't know the half, basically. Skullcap rap, take a seat. Bull rap partisan is lane, jump into another lane with me. But he's scared, so witness a bang with me. I brought the whole gang with me. Nico the Beast, the B came with me. Capo the King and Screwtape with me. Adlib with me. Jay Griff with me. Ass Mouse and Biz and Shay Kiss with me. Black Collar Biz and Tone Live with me. Voss and Voss with me, I brought them all with me. And if you ain't involved with me, me mug, cause we live the life that you dream of. Hi, y'all don't look so happy I'm here. Why y'all don't look so happy I'm here? Hi. Hi, y'all don't look so happy I'm here. Why y'all don't look so happy I'm here? Hi, Blab. Y'all don't look so happy I'm here. Why y'all don't look so happy I'm here? Hi, Facebook Live. Hi, Dreamers Podcast Anniversary Show. Hi, Joe Pardo. You can make noise at home.
What is up? That is awesome, man. That is awesome. That was great. It's great.
Thanks,
great. We like totally missed.
That was on camera. Hey, listen. That wasn't me, dog.
I know it was me. Hey, I totally.
Joe was like, I like how we totally missed. I'm like, I was in the range.
I was not. So I gotta shout out to Beatrice Feeney for donating $35 to Give Kids the World. Thank you so much, Beatrice. I also gotta give a shout out to Adam Starr for donating $35 to Give Kids the World. So yeah,
what's our
tally at now? So that's $75 plus my 29. So it's like 104, something like that, give or take.
There you go.
Yeah, so we're doing it. It's awesome. Anthony's in the house in Blab. If you want to come join us in Blab, it's superjoepardo.com/live. You click the link right above it, and you'll be watching Blab. And it looks like Anthony's actually calling in, so let's get him.
Oh, that's cool. I didn't know you could do this.
Yeah, that's why I was like, hey, you guys gotta come and hang out in the Blabs, because with Blab, you can join the chat. It looks like Anthony's at work.
Yes, sir.
Yo, what's going on, man?
What's going on, gentlemen? I see you got Rich Quick in the house, man. What's up,
yeah,
Rich?
What's up?
How you feeling, yeah, Anthony?
Good, man. I like those verses. That was nice, man.
Oh,
nice.
Man, thank you. Thank you, brother.
I was listening there.
I appreciate it.
You on lunch break, man?
Very cool. Yeah. Yeah, I'm on my lunch break. I want to make sure I jumped in here and
show my support for
such a great cause and support, you know, Dreamers Podcast as always.
Yes. I really appreciate the support, Anthony. It's been a lot of fun so far, and we're just getting started.
Just getting started.
you know, trying to raise money for the amazing cause, Give Kids the World. If you go to superjoepardo.com/donate, you can donate right to Give Kids the World. They bring children with life-threatening illnesses and their family down to Disney World. Totally free. Kids get parties at night and ice cream for breakfast, and they get tickets to all the parks. It's a wonderful cause, and I'm so happy to be able to support it through the show with the second anniversary of Dreamer Podcast.
Absolutely, I love it. Yeah, as soon as I jump off.
Nope. Uh oh, did we lose him? Oh. He's like, as soon as I jump off, and then he jumped off.
As soon as I jump off.
Oh, poor Anthony.
Well, we're sorry, Anthony. We lost your connection, man.
Well, thank you for calling. He's probably in like a building or something like that. He's going through a tunnel in a building. So let's see. Getting back to the things that's coming up for this year. For those that don't know, I have 3 projects going on. Right, 3 active projects that I'm working towards building.
What are you working on?
All right, so we'll start with this one, and I'll get to the others later. So I have for most people that know, I have a pretty, expansive background in business, right? I grew up in a family, my family's business, and since I was 6 and all that, learned a lot along the way from some pretty awesome people that have, pretty awesome experience, right? Like going back into like the 60s and even before that, even in the 50s, really. So I want to, with my third book. So my first book was basically like, it's like a mantra of Joe, right? Like 31 life-changing concepts. It's kind of like things that I try to live by. Am I perfect? No, of course not. I don't expect anybody to be perfect, but these are things that I try to live by. The second book supports my talk, the How to Dream and Big and Win. So the idea there is to wait. Oh no, is it letting him? I don't know if it's letting him in or not. Anthony was trying to get back in, but anyway, the idea was to have a book that supports my talk, help inspire others to dream big, and show them how they can win at the dreams that they want for themselves. That's really what's important. So, with the third book, I want to write a book that, gives a, not just a nod, but an outline of the things that I did to improve my family's business over the years. So the book is going to be called Sales Won't Save Your Business. And the reason...
Interesting.
Right. So, because to me, sales is like a treadmill. You can keep selling and selling and selling. And yeah, sales help, right? Like everybody, obviously, turning money over, even if you aren't making a profit, can still help in, at least keep you going.
Sales are essential.
I'm not saying that they're not. But when it comes down to it, one of the best ways and most overlooked ways, because everyone wants to be that I'm that power sell guy, right? I'm that guy that's, I'm the closer, I'm gonna sell, I could sell ice to an Eskimo, right? Like, the thing is not everybody's like that. Not everybody can teach people to be that person, and even those people can run into problems like market oversaturation. If your business has collections, like, collecting the money, you can run into problems where the money isn't going to come in fast enough to support the bills that you have. So, the book is called Sales Won't Save Your Business, and I forget what the tagline is, but something along the lines of boosting your bottom line through other methods of perform, like, that's not really the tagline. Like, I have an actual tagline, but my phone's doing Facebook Live right now, so I can't.
I got you.
So the idea is to go through the processes that I set up and have, like, the philosophies behind them to make your business more efficient. Because at some point, your sales will peak, right? They'll either they'll either plateau or they'll start to fall out because it's a fad or whatever, right? So the idea is if I have a business, I need to be utilizing as much as I can technology-wise, processes-wise. Like, I'm a pretty big process person, right? Like, you can break the rules, you can bend the rules, but you need rules in the first place to do either one of those.
Right.
So for me, it's like, okay, so I want to write a book about processes for business. Now, if you don't have a business, it might be a little boring, you know, of a topic. Or not boring, but because I promise you it won't be a boring book. But it won't be a very applicable book, except for the idea that you could optimize the things that you do on your daily life. But I don't really want to make it too broad. I'm looking for a very specific
book. Yeah, it's geared towards business people that have a business.
Managers and stuff like that. Because there is a fine line there where you can't turn up the efficiency so much that you actually turn off your employees.
Right. And
like, no free coffee for you.
But you know that these sort of things come across, like, speaking in terms of like sales, like a company like Walmart has, you know, way better sales than everyone else. Now, the impression that I get when I go there, though, is a different story. You know what I mean? So it leaves a bad taste in my mouth, even though it's doing great. You know what I mean? Their sales is doing great.
Right.
But there's things that they, maybe I shouldn't have said their name, but there's there's things that we could be doing better, you know, on the sales floor that would not only keep me going back, would keep me in the building longer.
That is true, and they don't necessarily have to be expensive things. So there's things along those lines about efficiencies for the process, but there's also efficiencies for the customer experience, because I try to be a very experience oriented person, creating experiences for people. Like when people come to my house, we generally have food. Like the arcade games that we have out in the garage and stuff like that. Like, I like creating experiences for people. I like bringing people into, this is like, they say it's Joey's Playhouse here. Like Pee-wee's on the wall over here, but this is Joey's Playhouse. And that's, you know, to me, that's what's important.
Let me tell y'all something. I rang the doorbell moments ago, before we started this live stream. I rang the doorbell and a magical, whimsical song played, and I was like, "Oh, that's very pleasant."
It's the theme from Up.
Oh, is that what it is?
Yeah, it's the theme from Up.
I was trying to pinpoint what it was.
Yeah. So, and that's a part that takes a lot of people off by surprise. Even we had what were they? Jehovah's Witnesses came to the door one day,
right.
and the one of the two ladies was like, "Oh my God, I want to ring your doorbell again!" Like, as soon as I opened the door, she's like, "I want to ring your doorbell again. That's so awesome!" I'm like, "Yeah, I appreciate that." And shout out to, I don't even remember what company made it, but actually, I bought it at Home Depot.
Really?
Yeah. They sell it. It's like $30 for it plays MP3s. Because originally I wanted a keyboard for a doorbell. So like, somebody designed this idea of like, you can make like a little like rectangular keyboard, and you can
play
the door, like the doorbell,
man,
like
that is dope.
But nobody ever did. So I was looking up all kinds of ways to do this. And I was like, oh, I'll wire up a computer, and I was like, well, you know, if the computer stops working or the power goes out, like,
yeah, then no way I can ring your doorbell.
Yeah, it's just, I was like, yeah, I don't know about that. I was like, I'd like to, but I just don't think it's going to work out for me.
Somebody come to my door when my power is out, I'm not answering.
Well, it's not about the power, but like the power.
That just sounds like a horror film waiting to happen. Power cuts out, you get a random knock on the door.
Well, that was like that guy, that comedian that was like, you know, when someone knocks on your door now versus 20 years ago, 30 years ago, you know, it used to be like, oh, company's here, it's amazing, yeah. And now it's like, people are like, ducking behind the couch,
yeah.
And like, if you're not calling me or texting me first, don't bother knocking on my door.
And definitely don't try to sell me no meat or shrimp that you got on some truck outside, neither.
I've gotten that once.
I hate that. What makes you think that I'm buying some T-bone steaks and some lobster tails off of you know, a door to door salesman.
Somebody's buying it.
Man, no, man, I'm not doing it.
That happened to me like a year. I think it was like the beginning of 2015. Somebody was like coming around, and I just happened to be outside.
Man, I have a you know what's crazy in my house. I have a bad reputation for losing my temper with those guys.
Oh,
isn't that terrible?
Well, you know, they're just trying to do their job, right? But their job sucks, so you're not making it any easier. But that's okay.
Door to door, like this is my place.
You know, you're on my property already. Yeah, already. Like you've already made that like choice to be on my property. Like, yeah. You didn't like
in my area. So that's all I'm saying.
You didn't get like a bullhorn from the street and yep, like
and I don't know you.
Knock knock.
And that insult injury, you're trying to sell me some bootleg filet mignon.
I don't know how you make bootleg. They got
the meat glue now. You never seen this? They got the meat glue. They glue these little scraps of meat together, make that joint look like a whole filet mignon.
Really?
Yeah, man, it's crazy.
That I had not heard.
Look out for it. Watch out. Don't buy any sort of meat of any door to door salesman.
Mm. Okay.
But anyway,
I won't be. That's for sure.
I just felt like I had to, you know, I felt like I had to inform these people, the people on Facebook Live, the people on Blab, like, they came on to watch us entertain them with these games and you know, learn a little something about life.
And now they have. They've learned that you shouldn't buy meat from a door-to-door salesman. That you don't have a bad experience to go on, do you?
And no, I don't. I just don't like them.
You're just assuming that it's a bad thing to buy because it just sounds shady.
It is shady. Man, listen. Show me somebody that's going door to door selling lobster tails out of a freezer truck, and I will show you somebody with multiple felonies. I'm sorry.
I guess. Yeah. I don't know about multiple felonies, but yeah. There's probably like some union that we're offending right now, like
Joe was like, "Don't worry, y'all. Rich Quick would not be invited back."
Oh, stop! Never. I should remind everybody that if you're watching right now, you should be going to superjoepardo.com/.
And the link to donate is...
I was already doing it.
Oh, my bad.
I didn't read it off the screen. SuperJoePardo.com/donate to donate to Give Kids the World. We're trying to hit $1,000 tonight. I don't know if we're going to do it, but last year we hit 600. So if we get close to 600, I will be elated that we were able to do that, especially given the fact that we don't have a big party here at the house like we did last year. It's just me and Rich. We're shouldering it, you know, together.
Yeah, we're growing in here.
Yes, we are. Whatever. I don't know what that means, but
we're growing. We're being bros, man.
Yeah. Oh. Okay. Yes.
We're growing
out. I can get down with that.
You thought I was dropping some street slang on the English podcast?
I had no idea.
It's like Rich, you've been saying a lot tonight.
So go to superjoepardo.com/donate. Give Kids the World, great organization. They do wonderful things for children with life-threatening illnesses, like bringing them down to Disney World and spending a week vacation with their family where they just get to be kids and not worry about doctor's visits and all that stuff. Great organization, can't say enough about them. Please go to superjoepardo.com/donate. And if you want to join us in the video chat, because we're here on Facebook Live, and we have some people popping in and out on Facebook Live. But if you want, come to Blab by going to superjoepardo.com/live. And Anthony is actually calling back in. So let's see if... Actually, I'm going to share the link on Facebook right now.
Welcome back, Anthony.
Thank you.
Yes.
We lost you a second.
Yeah, you were like, "Oh, I'll be right back." And
Got my internet cut out.
Oh,
I'm on the Wi-Fi here at work. I guess I got it in a dead spot.
Ah.
So.
So yeah, so
yeah, I was looking on the link. I typed in Super Joe Pardo /support by accident. I thought it was support. It's actually /donate. So you answered my question.
Oh, sorry about that.
What was funny was we both saw your comment at the same time, and then he started to say the link, and I started to cut him off to say the link because I was reading it on the screen as it happened.
Are we coming through loud enough on there? Anthony, are we coming through loud?
It sounds good. I'm glad.
Good. Glad to hear it. SuperJoePardo.com/donate. So Anthony, you actually have some big news. Unfortunately, I don't have it wired up so that people like could really hear you. I could turn it up a little bit though. Let's see. So you have some big news coming up very, very soon. I would love for you to talk about.
When you say big news, are you talking about the book?
Yes, the book.
I'm within weeks away from launching my first book, publishing my first book. And it's been a very exciting journey for me, and I'm really looking forward to just getting it out there for sale. It's been a long project, about 10 years, and it's finally being published. I've been holding off for a while, I guess you could say, just getting my ducks in a row, but I'm shooting for the 15th of June to publish the book. It's called The Science of Being, and it's going to be awesome.
Congratulations, brother.
Yes, congratulations, and I can't wait to have you as a guest on the Dreamers Cup podcast, finally, which will be awesome to be able to share, your book and everything, that you've done, and for those that don't know, Anthony has helped me out in several ways with this show, from promoting, like, this event with for getting people to go to SuperJoePardo.com/donate and donate to Give Kids the World.
And also that hashtag How to Dream on all social networks.
That too. Now
hashtag How to Dream.
Now Anthony, did you know that, I don't know if you got to hear earlier, but I got a phone call from that article, because of that article on Entrepreneur.com.
Oh, you got a phone call?
Yes. I mentioned this a little bit earlier. To potentially speak to female entrepreneurs in the Cleveland, Ohio area, which is it's like 8 hours from here, but that's okay. I'm not worried about that.
That's huge.
Yeah, it is. I gotta give a shout out to my man, and he's been on the show before, Kamanzi Constable, for not only just writing that article that was on Huffington Post, like what seems like forever ago now. But that article has now been shared with both Fox News and Entrepreneur.com.
Awesome.
Yeah, and
huge.
Shared it in a big way on Entrepreneur.com. So super thankful for him. He's been on the show before. You can go check it out. I'm not sure which episode he is. We're getting pretty far along.
Yeah, now it's getting hard. You're going to start forgetting episodes, man.
Yeah, once you get into the hundreds, I imagine it's hard to keep track.
Right. Well, I'm in the 200s, so
yeah, now
it's even tougher. And what's even tougher?
I don't even remember what I ate for breakfast.
Well, what's even tougher is that, like, I'm recording them, out of order, but like months ahead of time. So like I forget when I record them, and then I forget like when they went live, which makes it even tougher. So, But yeah, go check out Kamanzi Constable. If you go to SuperJoePardo.com and search Constable, you can check out his story. He has an amazing story, amazing books, writes amazing articles for the Huffington Post, Entrepreneur.com, gets to fly like all around the world. And he's real. He's a real dude. So super, super thankful for him, for what he's been able to help me with. And Anthony, of course, for all those that don't know, helped edit the book. Him along with Patrick I think I pronounced it wrong on the show too. He helped edit it, and as well as I think her name was Patty. I think her name is Patty. From Sweden helped edit it. So it was a contributed effort. And super thankful for all three of you for the help that was provided with that book. And you know, super excited for the future. I'm just super everything tonight.
Yeah, man, super Joe Pardo.
Yeah, man.
That's it.
Hashtag How to Dream on all social networks, and we in here raising money for a good cause. We raising money for charity, so make sure that you play the games with us. You at work?
You're at work.
You can't even.
Do you have Oreos?
Yeah. I was about to say, y'all got Oreos over there.
Yeah, you got an Oreo over there?
No, I got Pringles.
Well, it might be hard to get a Pringle from your forehead because of the. It's not flat.
And again, it might be easier.
I don't know. I'm not gonna
we're
have
not
your
gonna,
risk.
We're not gonna make
his,
you put a Pringle on your face, bro. And see where it goes. Don't worry.
Yeah, I ate them all anyway.
It sounded pretty empty.
When they say once you pop, you can't stop. I literally ate the entire container of the Pringles.
I am mad at that.
So, another thing to mention, Beatrice Feeney just pointed out that this is the 30th anniversary of Give Kids the World.
Really?
Yep.
What? That's awesome.
Yeah. Yeah, it is. And hopefully they have at least another 30 years in them. I think more than that, because last I heard, I think they were expanding their facility to make it even bigger. So that's exciting. You know, exciting news there. So, Rich, I think we need to get some peanut butter, some bread, and some ping pong balls out to.
That just sounds like it.
I don't even want to know.
Yeah, I know.
It sounds like a crazy
like,
party.
All right, y'all. Hey, listen. Do you think?
Yeah. Well, what the goal is we're gonna take bread. We're gonna put peanut butter on the bread. We're gonna put it at the end of this table over here that's just off camera, and we're gonna move the table over, and then we're gonna have to bounce the ping pong ball once to land on the bread. We gotta get two. We have six balls. If we land two, that will that's $10 for Give Kids the World. And if you want to help support Give Kids the World, which you should, because it's an amazing organization, you go to superjoepardo.com/donate to donate directly to Give Kids the World. We're already up to over $100 now, between me giving $29 and raising like $70-some from people, wonderful people like Adam Starr, who. If I don't know if you're watching Adam, but you need to come in the blab here. He's going to be on a future episode of Dreamers Podcast. Wonderful organization. I think it's adambrickguy.com. It's all about Legos. He collects Legos for kids to play with, like kids that are in homes that like the mom went to rehab. And the kid had nowhere to go, so they go to this home, and he brings these bricks into the home or into the place for the kids to play with.
That's awesome.
You know, and he's just getting started, man. He's just getting started. Absolutely wonderful. I donated, I think, three or four Lego sets to his organization. So, yeah, I gotta get better at pacing myself. Is that something that you do well?
What pace myself?
Yeah. No.
I kind of you see what I do, bro. I go off on these long tangents about door to door meat salesmen. That's my thing. You understand what I'm saying? There's no rhyme or reason to me, bro. I'm trying to follow your format.
Adam says he's definitely here. Adam, go to superjoepardo.com/live. Click the link just above the video of us talking right now. And join the blab session. So if you have, I don't know if you have a camera, Adam, but even if you don't, you can come in on the audio, and I'd love to get you in here to talk about your Brick Guy organization. Rich, do you have something that you can tell while I go get this bread and peanut butter?
Absolutely.
All right, I'll be back.
I actually have a question for Rich.
Sure.
Didn't you just drop an album recently?
I actually did just drop an album recently. I actually brought one for Joe, and I left it in the car, so you just reminded me I gotta get that.
And you were in tour where, in Europe?
I just got back from my second tour of the UK.
UK.
And awesome. And that was to promote the album. Basically, just coasting off the vibes of that, you know what I mean? But yeah, the project came out on Soul Spasm, and it did well, and we're really happy about it. And we got some videos coming soon also. So
cool.
Yep, still working, still pushing that project as far as we could take it, you know, while I'm working on new material, new music.
Yeah. Awesome. That's gonna be cool. Are you gonna be at Joe's conference by chance? You gonna be able to make it to that in September?
I plan on this actually. I don't remember. I hope that Joe didn't tell me about this conference and I forgot. Joe.
September 9th and 10th.
September 9th and 10th. Where's the conference?
Sweetsboro.
In Sweetsboro?
Yep.
Man, I'll be there.
Cool. Boom. Look forward to seeing you.
Excellent.
I left the ping pong ball.
Likewise. There. And so Joe is coming back with these. He got the. He got the bread with the peanut butter.
And I forgot
the ping pong balls.
The ping pong balls. All right. So let's see here. Let's put this back over here.
And just out of curiosity, how long is the link open to do the donations?
Forever. forever, or for like as much as forever is forever, I guess. Yeah, I had no plan on turning it off. Put it out.
Okay. Oh, yeah, because I'm on my lunch break at work right now, so as soon as I get home this evening, I'll definitely throw my support down for that.
Oh, thank you, Anthony. Thank you very much. I really appreciate it. And if you would like to throw your support in, you can go to givekidstheworld.com/donate to Give Kids the World. Help make some ice cream. Ice cream for breakfast happened for some kids. Let's see, we just got another donation from Ann Blackman, $35. Thank you
Excellent.
So much, Ann. Really, really appreciate it. You know, we're here doing everything we can to raise some money. That puts us it's probably just shy of $150.
I lost count.
I should probably update that thing. So it's like, let's see, 5. Oh, so let's see, 35.
Oh, Cole, jump in here.
35 plus the. Hold on, everybody. We're just updating our Facebook. No, we're updating our spreadsheet here of money.
Trying to figure out how many donations we have.
Why is this not working? Not cool. Not cool at all. Okay. All right. So I'm going to doing spreadsheet analysis here. Always a good thing to be doing on a live show.
A little spreadsheet analysis during the podcast anniversary. Never hurt nobody, let me tell you.
I know. Well, when it's for a good cause, you know. So we're at $139 right now. How awesome is that? And if you'd like to contribute to that, as we're about to contribute to that, I'm about to contribute to that by playing. Let's turn it this way so the balls don't go. This way. Because we don't want the balls to, you know what, we'll turn it this way. So maybe it's a little bit easier to see and be seen of that. All right.
Yeah, there you go.
All right, so we gotta get the Facebook Live camera. There we go. All right, so, so we gotta get two balls bounced off the table onto the peanut butter, right? Not too hard. And then for every ball after that, I'll do $2, right? So that's a total of 2 times 4, 8. That's a total of $18 if we get all six balls onto the peanut butter. That's ping pong balls. So, Rich, you were saying that this was going to be easy.
Yeah.
So you're more than welcome to take the bull by the horns here, man.
Now Joe is going to embarrass me because I definitely was talking all. Definitely was talking all the trash in the world earlier.
About how awesome you are at beer pong, right?
Yeah, no, I'm not.
Alright, so
I'm really not good at beer pong, and I'm not gonna be good at this either. But we're gonna try.
And
I gotta bounce it once and have it land in the peanut butter.
Yes.
All right, here we go. Ready? Now, I'm supposed to be keeping track, but since there's only six balls, we'll just go with six. All so right. You get six tries to get up to $18. All right. Not as easy as it looks. And if you would like to come and try this out at your house, get some ping pong balls, get some bread, and some peanut butter. Go to superjoepardo.com/live. Click the link. Boom, there's one and two. You got two more tries left, Rich. Come on, let's get $10 in there. Oh, come on, come on, come on, come on. Oh, so close. So close.
I guess we know why Rich's basketball career never took off.
I would agree. So yeah, if you want to call in and you want to, you know, play